You know, people have been asking me to write a book since I can remember. And, you know, I've tried writing books, but it just doesn't work. I get about two or three pages and then forget about it or get lost or something like that. And I think the reason it was pushed on me was later on after Forrest Gump, the movie, and people were saying, doggone it, you know, you're more like a real Forrest Gump. As a matter of fact, you've done more stuff than Forrest Gump did, and Forrest Gump wasn't even real. That's true. I did a lot more than Forrest Gump, I'll tell you that. Now, I didn't run back and forth across the United States jogging. But I did an awful lot more, and I did walk across Colorado. Should I write a book? No, I can't write. I'm really lousy at writing. So I thought I'm going to do a video book. And this is going to be like chapter one. And it's going to be like, should I really do a video book? Because that's going to be the question here. First thing I gotta do is think about it some more. I'm gonna go inside and see what this silliness looks like. Should I do this? A video book. Who ever heard of such a thing? Put myself out there like everybody can see me and they'll know all about me. And well, that's what they do if they can read, and they read a book, I guess, so. Okay. Well, we'll give it a shot. This is the beginning thoughts. Actually, I started thinking about it last night, but this is the real beginning thoughts. Write a book. I think I better shave. What do you think? Is this getting too long? Needs to be trimmed. Okay. Bye. So that sounded pretty mystical, huh? Yeah, I like that music. It creates a feeling sort of like an ambiance, you know. I was born at Fairview Park Hospital, but the hospital was built in the late 1800s, and it now exists somewhere else, and it's sort of a pretty fancy place. I have a couple pictures somewhere. But what makes this story so important are the number of things I did. And today, I went out and bought a board. I was reminded of it by Tim Russert, the newscaster for MSNBC. I believe he worked for NBC also, but passed away. He used a board and it had Florida, Florida, Florida on it. I guess it had something to do with how important it was going to be in the elections. So anyway, notwithstanding, I bought this board and I thought, I'll use this to draw up sort of like a story block and then maybe, or a timeline or something. and give you an idea of some of the things I did. And I'm going to have to go inside in the computer room with its green screen hanging from the wall with thumbtacks and do it very non-professionally that way. But it seems to be working. It looked okay. I do look pretty cool. It's trimmed only a little bit. So we'll switch back to inside and I'll give you some more info. Meanwhile, keep on rocking. Of course, you won't notice a difference in the time. I mean, this will switch just like... You remember the 60s? All the hippie stuff? Yep, we were there. Oh, you remember the riots in Cleveland? Well, there were riots in many towns. Black ghettos were rioting. We were there. Remember Kent State? When those students got killed, we were on the phone right away to our good friend Dr. Spock. We were there. We were there. We were there. This is my cowboy look. That's my hippie look for when I'm a hippie. There's my National Press Photographers Association hat. That's when I want to look official. That's my fishing hat. I don't like to fish anymore. Okay, well, that was pretty hard to follow, and I think probably the reason is I've done way too many things, and I haven't even started to list them yet, so I'm making out a storyboard. I think, you know, this way I'll be able to follow a timeline.
After all,
how are you going to be able to figure out what's going on here? It's just a whole bunch of stuff, and like I said, Forrest Gump, he wasn't real, but I was. And one word I want you to look up in your dictionary is enigmatic. You can look up enigma, E-N-I-G-M-A. There you go. At least I know how to spell it.